Praise the Lord. God is good all the time. God is good. Today it is Thursday where we are remembering how Jesus had the Last Supper with his disciples and how he was betrayed by Judas Iscariot and how he was taken to the high priest Caiaphas and how Peter denied him three times. Our reading is from the book of Mark, chapter 14, verse 22 to 25. The word of the Lord says, while they were eating, Jesus took a piece of bread, gave a prayer of thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples. Take, he said, this is my body. Then he took a cup, gave thanks to God, and handed it to them, and they all drank from it. Jesus said, this is my blood, which is poured out for many. My blood, which seals God's covenant. I tell you, I'll never again drink this wine until the day I drink it. I drink the new wine in the kingdom of God. Jesus prepared his disciples to have the Last Supper. And Jesus, when he did this, he wanted to institute the Lord's Supper. His disciples asked him where they would eat the Last Supper. And Jesus directed them to go to the city and they would find a man carrying a pitcher of water. They were to follow him and ask him where they were to have the Last Supper. This was done as Jesus has directed his disciples. It is good for us to know this, that the Lord Jesus Christ knows each one of us. And this message which I'm giving to you today is about having the presence of the Lord in our daily life. It is important to have Jesus in our daily lives. Whatever you are going through, when you have Jesus in your heart, when you have his presence, you will emerge victorious. Jesus said, this is my body. The bread represented Jesus' body. And it was a sign of Christ's presence with his disciples. Each time we celebrate the Lord's Supper, just as the bread is present with us, Jesus is present with us. Jesus is the bread of life. As our bodies need to be sustained by bread, our spiritual life needs to be sustained by Jesus. Jesus broke the bread. His body was broken for us. Jesus gave his body, his life for us. He came to give his life as a ransom for many. This we read from the book of Matthew, chapter 10, verse 45. Jesus says, take and eat. Jesus' life is a gift for each one of us, and we must take it. It is good to receive our Lord Jesus Christ. It's good to have him in our daily life, because we cannot make it without his presence. To eat Jesus means to share in his death. We must be broken. We must die. We must cast all our burdens upon the Lord Jesus Christ. When Jesus took the cup, he said, this is the blood of the new covenant, which is poured out for many for the forgiveness of sins. We must keep our part of the covenant in order to receive God's blessings. The new covenant is about forgiveness and salvation in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. It is important for all of us to keep our part of the covenant. The Passover was celebrated as a symbol of the Israelites' deliverance from Egypt. It is the fulfillment of the Passover, which will bring the new salvation of a new Israel for all believers, and the establishment of Christ's eternal kingdom in heaven. There are 4 points here to note. Let us walk with Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Let us cast all our burdens on Him. He cares for us. He knows our needs. He is the one who should rule in our hearts. Number two, Jesus will remove all kinds of fears in our journey. In our Christian journey, we encounter a lot of fears. It is only Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, who can remove all these types of fears. Number three, Jesus Christ will strengthen us in our daily life. Let us depend on Him, because He is our help at all times. Number four, Jesus will listen to our cry for help. He will never fail us. Let us not fail Him, because He is our Lord and Savior. In the name of God the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.